story to tell. The Vietnam War was the first war in which the role of helicopters was raised to a new level and used on a huge scale. The most popular helicopters used by the US during the Vietnam War were the Bell UH-1 Eagles. During the period from 1956 to 1973, the US produced a total of nearly 10,000 UH-1s of all kinds, of which more than 7,000 were brought to Vietnam. This was the helicopter that played the most important role for the US and its allies in this war. With its multi-purpose capabilities, the UH-1 TAPS can carry out the mission of carrying troops, cargo, fire support, and evacuation. Beginning in mass production in 1967, the Bell AH-1 Cobra is considered the United States Air Force's most successfully combat helicopter of all time. During the Vietnam War, the AH-1 Cobra helicopters performed a total of more than 1.6 million flight hours, accounting for one-fifth of all helicopters on duty on the Vietnam battlefield. Built in 1962, the US Cayman SH-2 helicopters were originally used as a high-speed multi-purpose helicopter. By the late 1960s, the United States had upgraded these SH-2 helicopters to anti-submarine warfare and early warning helicopters. However, on the Vietnam battlefield, SH-2 helicopters still mainly carry out transport missions, especially the establishment of an air bridge between aircraft carriers and destroyers of the US Navy to Saigon. The Sikorsky CH-37 Mojave was a heavy helicopter used by the US in relatively small numbers during the Vietnam War. With a maximum takeoff weight of up to 9.5 tons, the CH-37 was not only capable of carrying cargo, hoisting artillery, but also able to hoist other helicopters when they fell. The Piasecki H-21 was an extremely durable helicopter that has been produced by the US since 1952 and was used in the beginning of the Vietnam War. Nicknamed the Banana, this Mantaro helicopter was designed to operate in all types of weather and can perform well in environments with temperatures as low as minus 54 degrees Celsius. The H-21 was capable of carrying up to 12 fully armed soldiers and reached a top speed of 200 kilometers per hour. Although it had two propeller motors, this helicopter had only a single engine. The climate was so hot in Vietnam that the engine was often overheated, and the helicopter was soon retired when it was shot down heavily in Vietnam and fell repeatedly. In 1967, Banana was officially disqualified. The Hughes OH-6 Cayuse Light Reconnaissance Helicopter was an American light helicopter used in the Vietnam War with fire support and reconnaissance missions. The OH-6A helicopter was mass-produced from 1965 to present. OH6 had a top speed of 282 km per hour, a crew of 2 people, capable of carrying 7.62 or 12.7mm machine guns, with 70mm rockets and turret missiles. This allowed it to provide excellent fire support and with the high maneuverability of a light helicopter. The Sikorsky H-19 Chickasaw was a versatile helicopter used by the US Navy Air Force during the Vietnam War. With a maximum payload of about 3.4 tons, this helicopter was suitable for ground supply missions. However, due to its large size and slow flight speed, only about 160 km per hour, the H-19 was often an easy target for small air defense weapons. Even the North Vietnamese personal weaponry could shoot it down. By 1969, the H-19 was officially decommissioned. The Hera OH-23 Raven was used during the Vietnam War as a light helicopter for reconnaissance and navigation missions. Produced in 1948, this was a rare helicopter used throughout from the Korean War to the Vietnam War. It had a cruising speed of only about 153 km per hour. The open cockpit design of this helicopter made it possible to shoot down easily with the AK-47. Another unique helicopter used during the Vietnam War was the Cayman HH-43. It was a helicopter employing the synchrotron principle of enmeshing rotors, a unique design principle that dispenses with the need for a tail rotor. This type of helicopter was used exclusively for fire and rescue missions. These were the angels on the shoulders of American pilots when they were forced to skydive due to being shot down. Produced from 1962 to present, Boeing CH-47 Chinook is considered one of the most successful transport helicopters in the history of America. It has high speed, up to 315 km per hour, large capacity, up to 55 soldiers. The CH-47 is extremely maneuverable. It can place the rear door anywhere without having to land. After the Vietnam War, the rotor blades of the CH-47 were still spinning during the Gulf Wars, Iraq War. To this day, the CH-47 remains one of the most popular American transport helicopters. The Sikorsky CH-53C Stallion was a heavy transport helicopter used by the US Navy Air Force during the Vietnam War. This helicopter has very good maneuverability and huge payload, up to 19.1 tons in total. During the Vietnam War, the CH-53 specialized in airlifting missions with artillery, cars, and trucks to the battlefield. The Sikorsky CH-54 Tahi, with its unique crab claw design, was one of the helicopters used in the smallest number on the Vietnamese battlefield, even though it was very useful. Having a cruise speed of 240 km per hour, the CH-54 was famous for its enormous payload at that time, up to 21 tons. thanks to two T73P700 engines with a capacity of 4,800 horsepower each. My video of American helicopters used in the Vietnam War answer. Thank you for watching. If you find this video interesting, please give me your thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to support the channel. Goodbye and see you again in the next videos.